In the last lecture, we have learned about the real numbers, rational numbers and irrational numbers. One thing that I have to remind you again is that all rational numbers are P upon Q in the form, and therefore we can write them as decimals. The decimals can be terminating like 3 upon 2, answer will be 1.5. They can be non-terminating like 1 upon 3, which is 0.333333 recurring. But there are some numbers which are non-terminating and non-recurrent as well. Say for example, the value of pi. One scientist calculated it up to the 3000th place of the decimal, and yet there was no recurrence seen. Such numbers are usually called irrational numbers. Now, how can we find out if a particular number is a terminating decimal or a non-terminating decimal? The answer is very easy. We know that if a number is written as P upon Q, and if Q is in the form of 2 raised to X into 5 raised to Y, then it is a terminating decimal. Remember, whenever the Q is in the form of 2 raised to X multiplied by 5 raised to y, this fraction is always a terminating decimal. Now, what do we understand by this? Let us put P as P, Q is 10. Now, 10 will be equal to 2 raised to 1 into 5 raised to 1. And therefore, this decimal, we all know whatever number we put as P, then it will be a terminating decimal. All we have to do is shift the decimal one place to the left. Same way, if it is P upon 20, then 20 can be written as 2 square into 5 raised to 1. Therefore, this number 2 will be a terminating decimal. From this we can conclude that any number, the factor of which is anything other than 2 and 5, any number the factor of which is anything other than 2 and 5, and we do not consider 1 here. Any number which has a factor other than 2 and 5 will never give a terminating decimal. Only numbers who have two factors, 2 and 5, again we don't consider 1 here, 2 and 5, then it will give us a terminating decimal. Let us also remember one law of power and indices. How do we write square root of 4 in the form of powers and indices? This can be written as 4 raised to 1 upon 2. The rule said a raised to the power of 1 upon x is x root of a. We will have to use this in this lesson quite often. But let us do our first exercise from the textbook. If you have your textbook in hand, open page number 14. We have exercise 1.3. Write the following decimal form and say what kind of decimal expansion each has. That is our first question. And the first sum of the first question is 36 upon 100. Now what is 100? 100 can be factorized as 2 square into 5 square. No other number other than 2 and 5, and therefore this will be a terminating decimal. And we get the answer, because there are 2 zeros, we can write this as 336.0. We shift this decimal 2 places to the left and we get the answer as 36. Very simple thing. However, we can even do it by division. 36 divided by 100, 0, put a point, put a 0 here, we have 3, we have 300, 60, a 0 more, 6, and we have 600, and we have the final answer as 0.36 with remainder 0. And therefore, it is a terminating decimal. The second one is 1 upon 11. The second sum, 1 upon 11. Now what are the factors of 11? 1 and 11, we never consider 1, and therefore this will be a non-terminating decimal. And now let us go for the division. 11, 0, point, we have a 0. We put a 0, 1 more 0, and we have 9. And the answer will be 0.09090909. It can also be written as 09 recurring or 0.0 with a dot on the top and 9 with a dot on the top. When we put the dots on both numbers, that will mean both numbers will keep recurring in the same order. Go over to question number or sum number 3. Four integer 1 upon 8. We multiply 4 with the denominator 8 I just add 1, 32 plus 1. We get 33/8. Now 8 can be factorized as 2 into 2 into 2, which is 2 cubed. If q is in the form of 2 raised to x multiplied by 5 raised to y, we can write this as 8 into 5 raised to 0. Remember friends, a raised to 0 is always equal to 1. And therefore this will be a terminating decimal. Let us divide and find out. And our answer will be 4.125 with a remainder 0. So even before going through the entire division, we can find out if it is a terminating or a non-terminating decimal. Whether it will be recurrent or no, we will not be able to say. But terminating or non-terminating, we would definitely be able to find out. Go over to question number, sum number 4. Thirteen has only two factors, 1 and 13. We don't consider 1, and therefore this is going to be a non-terminating decimal. Let us do the division. We don't see anything recurring over here, and therefore it is a non-recurring decimal. Let us go over to sum number 5. The sum is 2/11. 11, we say that if we exclude 1 as only one factor, that is 11, and therefore it is going to be a non-terminating decimal. we start dividing. And the answer will be 0.18 recurring, which can also be written as 0.1 with a dot on the top, 8 with a dot on the top. We find that 1818 will keep on recurring in the same order, and therefore it is non-terminating. Recurring decimal. Sound a little funny. उसमें क्या है टाइप ऑफ स्टेटमेंट, बट इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट स्टेटमेंट. द स्टेटमेंट सेज दैट व्हेनेवर यू आर डूइंग अ डिविजन ऑपरेशन, द रिमाइंडर विल नेवर बी मोर देन द डिवाइडेंड. दैट मीन्स इफ we do the operation P divided by Q, we get the answer as quotient multiplied by Q plus the remainder. R will always be less than Q. Always be less than Q. This will help you do your second question. Let us go over to the third question. Express the following in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are integers Q not equal to zero. We have the first question as 0.6 written. I have showed you how to solve this question in the last period. We say that equation 1, equation 2, now remember 6 upon 9 is not the simplest form, and hence we cannot leave the question at this point. We will have to bring 6 upon 9 to its simplest form. So we factorize 6 and we factorize 9. We find the common factor 3, and therefore x will be 2x 2 upon 3 as our final answer. The next one is zero point four and only 7 recurring. It is very important to look at the question very clearly and with concentration, because instead of a dot, if a dash is put on top of 7, chances are that you may feel that the dot, the dash, is extending on 4, and you may take it as 0.47 recurring. It will not be correct. You will not be attempting the question in the book. So when we look at the question carefully, we find that it is 0.4 and only 7 is recurring. For this equation 1. Now we will have to bring both these numbers to the left of the decimal. And therefore, let us multiply it with 100 for this equation 2. This sign is easy, but what do we get here? We get 47.3/99. We remove the decimal, and our answer will be 473/990. Remember, you cannot leave the question at this point. Same way here, because there were common factors in B and Q, you cannot leave the question here. You have to reach the simplest form, and you cannot leave the answer with a decimal in the numerator or the denominator. Remove the decimal and finally you come to the correct answer. In the third, we have 3 recurring decimals. All 3 are recurring. Let me make it more clear. All 3 recurring. To begin with, and for an equation. Now, because we want to shift 3 of them to the left of the decimal, we obviously multiply it with for an equation 2. Subtracting equation 1 from equation 2, we get 1000x minus x equal to 1.0014 recurring minus 0.0014 recurring, and therefore what we get is 999x equal to 1, and x will be equal to 1/999. So depending upon the number of digits you want to the left of the decimal, you have to use the number of zeros. If you want only one digit to move to the left of the decimal, you multiply with 10. If you want two digits to move to the left of 0, you multiply with 100. And when you want three digits to be shifted to the left of the decimal, you multiply it with 1000. If there are 4, we multiply with 10,000, 5, 100,000, and so on. Two questions from exercise 1.3. We are yet to do exercise 1.1 and 1.2, which will be your homework. And the remaining part of exercise 1.3. I again give you a hint. Square root of a is a raised to 1/2, that is x root of a is a raised to 1/x. This will be helpful to you during the exercise.